QuickTime is a video player that comes bundled with Mac computers. In addition to playing videos, QuickTime has the capability of recording a movie from your laptop's camera, as well as the audio and screen of your Mac or any connected iOS device, such as an iPhone, iPad, or iPod Touch. Hi, this is Karen McKee, the scientist videographer. In the previous tutorial, I showed how to use QuickTime to trim, split, or combine multiple video clips shot with a GoPro camera. In this tutorial, I'm going to be focusing on using QuickTime to record a movie. Let's start with recording a movie. Open QuickTime Player, then go to File and select New Movie Recording. This will open your FaceTime HD camera, which is what you want to use if you're planning on recording yourself speaking to the camera, as I'm doing now. If you hover your cursor over the player window, you'll see this box, which shows the record button and some other options. So let's take a look at those. If we click on this little symbol next to the record button, we see a list of all connected cameras, microphones, and the choice of quality of your recording. And you can see that I just have the FaceTime HD camera operating, and I have two microphones, the built-in microphone on my computer, and I have an external microphone connected to my computer, which is what I'm actually using to record this tutorial. And you can see that I have this the recording set to maximum quality. And the other option here is you can, if you have headphones or earbuds connected and you want to listen to the audio as you're recording, you can change the volume here with this scroll bar. Now, your audio recording will be greatly improved if you use an external microphone. Now, most people have earbuds that contain a microphone, and let's see what happens when I connect this to my computer. And so now let's look at the list of microphones. So now you see that the built-in microphone has changed from internal to external, indicating that the recording would be, the audio would be recorded through this microphone. Then all you do is just click record, and the recording will start, and when you're ready to stop the recording, just click it again and the recording stops. And now you see that there is automatically a file, an untitled file, that appears on the desktop. And all you need to do now is retitle and save that file. You can also record anything running on an iPhone, iPad, or iPod Touch device that is connected to your computer via a Lightning port and is running iOS 8 or later. I've just connected my iPhone, and so now I can select that phone to record video and audio. When I select the phone, we can see the screen in the QuickTime window. Perhaps I want to record a tutorial showing how to use a phone app, for example, iMovie for iOS. When I click record on the QuickTime window, I can then begin demonstrating how to use iMovie on my phone, and all of those actions will be recorded by QuickTime. In other words, your iPhone screen is being mirrored, and all the actions that you are taking on that device is being recorded in QuickTime. When I stop the recording, I will have all of that footage captured in a QuickTime file. If there was audio playing on the phone, that would be recorded as well. And so here I'm playing back a video previously recorded on my iPhone, and QuickTime is now recording both the video and the audio playing on my phone. And when I play it back, you can hear the audio that was playing on my phone. If I instead wanted to record a voiceover while showing my iPhone screen, I would change the microphone to one of the other options. Perhaps you wish to create a podcast. The audio recording option is even easier to use. Just select New Audio Recording, and then select the microphone you wish to use, and click the record button to start and stop the audio recording. The last option is to record your computer screen. You may want to demonstrate a computer program, for example, or perhaps you want to show a PowerPoint presentation while recording your voice explaining each slide. Here's an example of a PowerPoint presentation, and if we want to record the computer screen, we go to File and select New Screen Recording. And then we need to select the microphone that we're going to record our voice with, and you can select one of the external microphones or your internal microphone in your computer. Then we hit record to begin the recording, and we're given some instructions to click on the screen to record the full screen, or we can drag a window to record just part of the screen. But that's not what I want to do. I want to record the PowerPoint presentation playing a slideshow. So I'll start the QuickTime recording by clicking on the screen, and so now it's recording, and now I'm going to start the slideshow for the presentation, and so now I can record my presentation and explain each of my slides as they're being shown here. And so to stop the recording, just tap the icon in the menu bar, and a dialog box will come up allowing you to name your recording and save it to a folder. Now, a couple of tips here. It helps to have a prepared script for your audio when you're going through your PowerPoint slides, and also it helps to practice your speech before you do the recording. Another tip is to record your speech in short clips that you can edit together later. This way, if you are recording a 15-minute talk, for example, and mess up during the last minute, you won't have to start all over again at the beginning. Once you've finished your recording, you can use QuickTime to trim or combine clips to create the final version for publishing on your website or on a media sharing site. See the link in the annotation to watch my video on editing with QuickTime. Well, that's a quick walkthrough of how to record video and audio with QuickTime. For more tips and tutorials, visit my website or check out my ebook, which is available in the iTunes Store and is readable on an iPad, iPhone, and Mac. Thanks for watching, and if you found this tutorial useful, please like my video or leave a comment.